Hey everyone, what's up guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are enjoying my content. If you like my content, please let more people know about my channel so that it will be helpful to them also. Now for my today's topic, this video will be a dedicated video on the Alliance Battle. To reach this Alliance Battle, you have to tap enter and you have to tap arena. Here the third tab is called Alliance Battle and you have to tap it. Now we entered this Alliance Battle mode. Here on my left hand side, you can see the ranking of all the alliances in the game and also the rank of the alliance you are currently staying. Second tab is our rank in our alliance, and the third tab is our rank in the entire game. Now this is what the things available on my left hand side. Now moving on my right hand side, it's just saying the name of the enemy, which is Frost Beast, and it's saying this is a normal mode, and also this is saying the requirements of this mode, which is a combat type character. Now at the bottom of my screen, you can see the schedule like this. This is currently round 9, which will end in 3 hours 38 minutes, and after 3 hours 38 minutes, round 10 will be activated like this. And each and every rounds will be having a separate requirements. As you can see, for normal mode, for today's round, which is round 9, we are having a combat type requirement, and for round 10 we are having a blast type requirement, and for round 11 we are having a speed type requirement. Like this, these requirements will change from round 1 to round 14. Not only these requirements guys, you have to watch for the extreme mode requirements also. Usually sometimes these requirements will match each other. Second tab is just lists, and here if your alliance is rank 1 in the alliance battle, we can get these rewards, and if your alliance is rank 2, and we can get these rewards, and like this till 50%. We can get only rewards up to 50%. After 50%, we will not be receiving any rewards from Alliance Battle. The weekly MVP most wanted player will receive this 5500 crystals, which will be a top player in the top alliance. Now moving on, let's click enter for today's round. Now you just have to click normal, and here it's showing the requirements for normal mode as well as extreme mode. Sometimes these two requirements will match each other. You have to pick your characters very carefully. For example, if Captain America is the main character which you thought of using in the extreme mode, but if you forgot and use him in the normal mode, you cannot Captain America character in the extreme mode. Yes guys, characters used in the normal mode cannot be used in the extreme mode. It's just written here also. Now entering in the normal mode, we have to pick three characters. You can pick whichever character you like, all the combat characters only. As you can see, this normal mode requirement is combat, so it will show only combat type characters. It won't show blast type characters or universal like this remaining characters. It will show only combat type characters, and out of this combat type characters, you can pick whichever character you like. For me, I am just going to pick these three. I can pick some other characters also, but I am very sure that I am not going to use these three characters in my extreme mode. So I am going to use these three. After selecting these three characters, you just have to click start. Normal mode is just finished, as you can see, and this is our score. If we finish this normal mode successfully, our score will be this much. And now you just have to click progress button like this. And here also in the extreme mode, usually this thing is called Alliance Battle Extreme or ABX. Here on my left hand side, you can see the name of the enemy is Frost Beast, and this is an extreme mode, and here it is recommended to use an attack with silence. So I hope you guys remember my previous videos about skills and their effects, like only certain characters with certain skills will be having silence. For example, let's go to characters like Captain Marvel, and if you go to her tier 3 skill, here only you can see 4 second silence. Yes guys, some characters may not have silence. Moving on, let's go back, and here you can see as there are no type requirements, here you can use all types of characters. You can use a combat type character, or you can use a blast type character, or you can use a speed type character, whichever character you like. All the available characters you can use them, but usually people use very good build characters to reach higher scores in the Alliance Battle Extreme. Usually characters with the custom gears called Rage custom gears reach higher scores. Not only this, Rage custom gear plays a major role here, the good cards also play a very major role here. If you are looking for higher scores, usually the characters with Rage will be very useful in this Alliance Battle Extreme mode. Out of all the characters, I suggest the characters like Luna Snow or the characters like Neymar will be. Not only these custom gears and comic cards guys, these higher scores are also depend on your attack pattern or boss attacking pattern. For example, you can use all the characters available here, but the boss, there is a certain skill which boss usually uses in this ABX. If the boss able to use his special skill, that boss defense will be increased. You have to stop that. But the only skill stop that boss roar is called silence skill. So you have to use a character with silence. You can use this Jean character also, because in her tier 3 skill we can see silence. There is a 4 second silence here. Now let's go back, and you can play this mode without having the silence in one of your skills. For example, you can play a team like this, as Sharon Rogers doesn't have silence in any of her skills, so you can still play this ABX, but you cannot reach the higher scores. To reach the higher scores, even though Sharon Rogers having a Rage custom gear and your cards are very good, still you cannot reach the higher. Now in the battle, I am going to show you guys how to counter this boss attack. Now you just have to click start. This is the Alliance Battle Extreme. Now you have to tap the screen, and Nick Fury 5th skill is a buff skill. It will apply to not only this character, but if you tag some other character, this buff will be applicable to that character also. Now tap that skill and tag in your Captain Marvel character, and this buff apply to that Captain Marvel also. Now just remember guys, if you want you can note it down, this boss roar usually appears at the timer 2 minutes and 8 seconds and 1 minute and 19 seconds and 37 seconds. You just have to remember it, or you can note it down. This is the almost exact times when the boss roar will be appear. So whenever you see that timer is near, you have to make sure that silence skill is available like this. Now we are attacking this beast constantly. Now just remember that Captain Marvel first skill also gives us silence, but to activate that first skill silence, you need to activate her 5th skill first. Now the timer is near. Now let it go to the center, and now tap the 5th skill, and now the 1st skill. Now the boss roar has been broken. Now we can constantly attack the beast without having its defense buffed. I already reached my max score guys, that's why I am playing like this. Please do not play like this. You always constantly attack the boss so that your score will be increased. Appearing just tap fifth skill and fifth or first skill. Now again this boss roar is cancelled. Now we can constantly attack the enemies without having its defense buffed. Like this guys, it will work, I hope. I hope you guys understand this. If you didn't, please, or if this is not clear enough, please let me know in my comment section. I will try to dedicate one more video. Well guys, that's it for today's video. I hope everyone enjoyed my content. And one more thing, please be kind to one another. I hope I earn the privilege of your time.